Today we are revisiting the Gunfighter Magnum. Now this weapon has undergone some changes during the weapon tuning phases of Halo 5, and whether they were good or bad really depends if you like using the gun or not. So I'm not really going to focus on that debate. Instead, let's take a closer look at some of the Gunfighter Magnum stats and discuss them. Right off the bat, let's look at the red reticle ranges. As always, these are the effective ranges, and within them you will have stronger bullet magnetism and aim assist. So the hipfire red reticle range is 23.13 meters, and the SmartLink red reticle range is 27.62 meters. Now these are the rebalanced ranges, and if you were wondering what they were originally, it was 29.24 meters for hipfire and 37.96 meters for SmartLink. So about a 6 meter decrease for hipfire and about a 10 meter decrease for SmartLink since the rebalance. Moving on, in terms of rate of fire, the Gunfighter Magnum shoots 5 rounds per second, which is faster than the standard Magnum's 4 rounds per second, and reloading takes about 1 second. This weapon also has some of the fastest handling in Halo 5, and if you don't know what handling is, it is basically the stat that represents how fast you aim, draw, and put away your weapon. In general, the handling of lighter weapons tends to be much better than handling for heavier weapons. For example, if we just compare the draw times only of some weapons, we'll get a better understanding of this concept. The draw time for the Gunfighter Magnum is 0.1 seconds, which is fast as hell. For a standard Magnum, the draw time is 0.2 seconds, which is also fast. Now for an assault rifle, its draw time is 0.33 seconds, and for a sniper rifle, it is 0.66 seconds. So 6 times longer than the Gunfighter Magnums. In other words, you can fire a Gunfighter Magnum way faster when you switch to it compared to heavier weapons. In the heat of combat scenarios, this can be quite beneficial if you are trying to finish off a low health enemy. So in a nutshell, that is the Gunfighter Magnum's handling stat. It's slightly more complicated than this, but we'll leave it at that for simplicity for now. Anyway, let's talk about the times to kill. For the headshot bonus, we are looking at a TTK of 1.2 seconds requiring 6 shots, so 5 shots to break the shield and 1 headshot. The body TTK is 1.6 seconds requiring 8 shots. Now how good are these times to kill? Well, to understand this, we have to compare them to the Gunfighter Magnum's competitors. So 343 said the role this gun has in Halo 5's sandbox is to function as a rapid fire sidearm, essentially competing against the SMG, AR, and Storm Rifle. So these are the weapons we will compare the Gunfighter Magnum to. The Storm Rifle has no headshot bonus and has a TTK of 0.9 seconds. The SMG has TTKs of 1.2 seconds and 1.3 seconds for the headshot bonus and body shots respectively. And finally, the AR has TTKs of 1.2 seconds and 1.9 seconds for the headshot bonus and body shots respectively. So essentially, these stats speak for themselves. The Storm Rifle kicks ass with a TTK of 0.9 seconds, and the SMG, AR, and Gunfighter Magnum are tied at 1.20 seconds for ideal TTKs. In terms of body TTKs, the Storm Rifle gets first place again, SMG second, Gunfighter third, and AR fourth. Now, an additional factor we must take into consideration is something called forgiveness. Automatics in general have more forgiveness than semi-automatics when it comes to aiming, since you don't have to be as precise on your targets and you can quickly make up for missed shots with their high rates of fire. For example, we all know missing a shot with a DMR is much worse than missing a shot with an AR. Anyway, that's basically my point. The Gunfighter Magnum is a semi-automatic sidearm that competes against automatics at close range. In other words, at around the 10 to 15 meter range, it will be much easier and more efficient to use a Storm Rifle SMG or AR instead of the Gunfighter Magnum. Now, does that make the Gunfighter Magnum useless? Well, ask yourself this: when have you used the Gunfighter Magnum? When do you see other players use it? That's right, almost never. I rarely use this gun, I rarely see other players using this gun as well. But since taking the time to revisit this weapon, all I have to say is give this weapon a chance, if you still play Halo 5. For a level 2 rec, it is a very good gun. Not only because its TTK is 1.2 seconds, but also because it does not have the same problem that affects the Storm Rifle, SMG, and AR. And what is that problem? It's distance. The in-game time to kill for automatic weapons becomes longer as distance increases. Now a lot of you already noticed, and this is no surprise given the fact that these weapons have reticle bloom, which results in worse accuracy the further you are from the target. So beyond that 15 meter range mark, the Storm Rifle, SMG, and AR TTKs will start to become longer and longer, to the point at where it will take around 2 to 3 seconds at least to kill an enemy. Your aim can be perfect, but your weapon's shots will miss because of the reticle bloom. Now obviously burst firing with automatics helps with accuracy, but you're sacrificing rate of fire for precision, which results in longer TTKs as well. Now what about the Gunfighter Magnum? Does it have the same accuracy issues as a Storm Rifle, SMG, and AR? And to put it simply, no, it does not. This gun can easily maintain its ideal time to kill of 1.2 seconds up to 30, 40, and even 50 meters away. Though I will say the 40 and 50 meter range mark is definitely pushing the limit, you'd have to be really good at aiming in Halo 5, and you'd have to control recoil and reticle bloom as well. But although the Gunfighter Magnum does have a little bit of reticle bloom, it still functions pretty well as a semi-automatic precision weapon. Whether you hit the target depends on how good your aim is and whether you can control the weapon's recoil, which is an advantage the Gunfighter Magnum has over the Storm Rifle, SMG, and AR at close range and medium range. With those weapons, you have to mostly worry about reticle bloom and whether you need to burst fire, while for the Gunfighter Magnum, it is the recoil. So we can do a quick bullet spread test and see the exact recoil pattern we need to be aware of. For both hipfire and smartlink, it is vertical and slightly directed towards the right. Thus, this is basically what you need to counter when using this weapon. And once you get the hang of it, it's actually not that difficult. Furthermore, you can significantly increase the stability when firing the Gunfighter Magnum by simply crouching. This greatly decreases recoil and allows the weapon to be more accurate. Now, as all of you are seeing, this gun does have some reticle bloom, so there is some randomness with its accuracy. However, within the Gunfighter Magnum's red reticle ranges, this is not an issue. This gun's accuracy and bullet magnetism, although it seems like it's slightly worse, pretty much they work the same way as the standard Magnums, and it will counter the reticle bloom. Now, once you go outside the red reticle ranges and engage in gunfights, sometimes the bloom will cause you to miss shots. In testing, it became more problematic beyond that 35 meter mark, but that's past the Gunfighter Magnum's intended combat range, so it's fine. Besides, I would not recommend using it beyond 30 meters as this is already going into that medium range. Unless, of course, you want to mess around and dominate someone from 50 meters with a Gunfighter Magnum. Anyway, given these characteristics, good accuracy beyond close range, maintaining the ideal TTK of 1.2 seconds unlike its competitor weapons, overall snappiness and excellent handling, the Gunfighter Magnum has some unique advantages over its competition. Mastering the Gunfighter Magnum is definitely worth it, but if you just don't like using this weapon, that's fine. Different players prefer certain weapons over others, so use whatever weapon you're most comfortable with. But I hope this video helped you better understand the Gunfighter Magnum, because your excellence with this weapon can be a deadly force in combat. As always, thank you for watching, and until next time.